to Don Bosco College. You are watching Bosco Campus Vision, the campus television channel of Kottayam Don Bosco College. And this is the second lecture of Unit 1 of the syllabus, Informatics and Cyber Law. And in this lecture, we will define what is a computer network, the different benefits of computer networks, the different types of computer networks, and network topologies. What is a computer network? A computer network is linking two or more computing devices for the purpose of sharing data and sharing resources. A computer network can be defined as an interconnection of two or more computers or computing devices attached with the communication media for the purpose of sharing information and sharing resources. A computer network can be a simple network or a complex network. A simple network may be connecting only two computers or one computer and a printer. A complex network may be connecting millions of computers and computing devices. So there are different types of computer networks. Some are simple computer networks, others are complex computer networks. What are the benefits of computer networks? The first benefit of computer networking is sharing of peripheral resources. The resources like a printer or memory or scanner can be shared in a network. The second benefit of computer network is sharing of programs and data. In organizations, people use the same software and need to access the same information. A network will enable us to share software and to share data. The third benefit of networking is better communication. Computer network facilitates communication among users. Email is an example of a communication mechanism that is available in the internet. Another benefit of computer networking is security of information. The security of information is much more in networks. If a standalone machine is not working, if a single machine is not working, the data stored in the hard disk cannot be used. However, if the machine is part of the network where storage is in the hard disk, data can still be accessed and saved onto another storage device from another workstation. So, there is more security of information in a network. Another benefit of networking is access to database. Networks will enable the users to access different databases at the same time by using different softwares. This helps the users to access the private company databases or public databases available online through the use of the internet. Another important benefit of networking is sharing internet connection. Using a network, different systems can access the internet connection simultaneously from a single internet service provider account. We can see it implemented in internet cafes. A single internet connection can be shared by different computer systems, or a single internet connection can be shared by different computers in an organization. Thus, a network will enable sharing of internet connection. Having defined what is a network and the benefits of networking, we shall now discuss the different types of networks. The different types of networks that we will discuss are local area network, metropolitan area network, wide area network, personal area network, and campus area network. What is a local area network or LAN? Computers connected within a geographical area, an office, or within a building is called as a LAN or a local area network. The data transmission in LAN is very fast. LANs have fewer errors. LANs are used in banks and universities and other institutions. So, local area network is a network that is existing within an institution, within a building. There are some advantages for LAN. LAN is beneficial in customer service aspect. The customer can approach any terminal, any system that is connected to a local area network. LAN permits shared use of hardware and software. Terminals can communicate with each other using messages. The speed of data transfer is very high in LAN. The LAN system has a very high security as well. Thus, the local area network has lot of advantages. There are some limitations for LANs as well. The first limitation is that the maintenance cost of LAN is very high. Complicated, high quality software is required in local area networks. Another limitation is that the geographical area that is covered by a LAN is very limited. It is only within an institution. In a LAN, if the system is not properly used, some fraudulent users may access the data of other users. Metropolitan area network or MAN. A metropolitan would mean a city. So, a large geographical area limited within a city is known as a MAN. A MAN provides network communication between different business houses or between the branches of a bank. The setting up of a MAN is very complex than LAN. It can connect various LANs in a city. The cable TV network spread over a city can be termed as a MAN. A MAN operates over an area of around 100 kilometers radius. So, a network that covers a city can be called as a metropolitan area network or a MAN. Wide area network or WAN. A WAN is a computer network that spans a very large geographical area. This is the largest network and it covers the maximum geographic area spread over cities, states or between countries. Since it covers a very large area, its data transferring rate is quite slower than the MANs and the LANs. So, the largest network that is covering the largest geographical area is a WAN and internet is a WAN. WAN uses telephone lines, satellite communication, microwave transmission, etc. And these transmission media are linked with a connecting device called router. A router is a device which will interconnect two or more networks. And as I have mentioned already, the largest WAN that is existing today is the internet. Personal area network or PAN. A computer network used for communicating between computer devices like printers, fax machines, scanners, etc. close to a computer system is known as a PAN, personal area network. The reach of PAN is limited to 20 to 30 feet. Campus area network or CAN. A CAN is ideal for universities and other educational institutions. It connects computers in a number of buildings within a campus. So, it is known as campus area network. So far, we have discussed what is a network, the benefits of networking, the different types of network. Now, we will discuss the different network topologies. The different network topologies we will discuss are the bus topology, ring topology, star topology, mesh topology and hybrid topology. What is network topology? The geometrical arrangement of computer resources, remote devices and communication facilities is known as network topology. It is the way in which the computing devices are arranged in a network. It is a pattern of interconnection of nodes in a network. Each computer device in a network is called as a node. The most widely used topologies are star topology, bus topology, ring topology, tree topology, mesh topology and hybrid topology. So, a network topology is the way in which the computer devices are connected in a network. What is a bus topology? In a bus topology, each computer is connected to a single communication cable. There is a central communication cable, as you see in the diagram, to which all the computer devices are connected. So, we can say there is an interface to which all the computers can connect and communicate. This topology is used in traditional data communication network, where the host of one end of the communication can connect with several other hosts using a central communication cable. So the best topology makes use of a central communication cable to which all the computing devices are connected. A ring topology, as you can see in the diagram, the ring topology takes the form of a ring. In a ring or a loop or circular topology, several computers are connected to each other in a closed loop by a single communication cable. In ring topology, each node is connected to and only two neighboring nodes. Each node is connected to two neighboring nodes, and the communication can be either unidirectional or bidirectional. Unidirectional would mean that the communication will take place only in one direction. Bidirectional would mean that the communication can take place in both the directions. Star topology. In a star topology, there is a host computer or a central hub which is attached to local computers through multiple communication lines. All the communication between local computers must pass through this central hub. In other words, local computers are not directly connected to each other. All of them are connected to this host computer. All of them are connected to this central hub. Star network is used widely in banks. So, star topology is an arrangement of computers in which all the computers are connected to a central hub, a central host. Tree topology. In a tree topology, the shape of the network is that of an inverted tree, an upside down tree, with a central root branching and sub-branching to the extremities of the network. A tree topology is best suited for applications in organizations where headquarters communicate with the regional offices and regional offices communicate with district offices and so on. So, a tree topology is an arrangement of computers in the form of an inverted tree. Mesh topology. In mesh topology, each node is connected to every other node. So, this will enable an alternative route in case one host is not working or one host is too busy. This topology is ideal for long distance networking because it provides extensive backup and rerouting capacities. In mesh topology, communication between nodes is possible either directly or by passing through. So, in mesh topology, every node is connected to every other node in the network. Now, we will go on to discuss the last type of topology known as the hybrid topology. A hybrid topology is a type of network topology that uses two or more network topologies. One segment of the network may be a ring topology. The other segment of the network may be a bus topology. The third segment of the network may be a star topology. So, it uses a combination of bus topology, mesh topology, ring topology, or star topology. So, a hybrid topology consists of a number of network topologies used in a network. So, we have come to the end of the second lecture of Unit 1, and in this lecture we have discussed what is computer networks, the different benefits of computer networks, the different types of networks and network topologies. Thank you for your patient listening and hope to see you for our next lecture.